Jeeves, there you are.
Sit down, sit down.
Good afternoon, sir.
Observe the time, Jeeves.
Yes, indeed, sir. Not yet 3:30.
Yes, perhaps you think it odd that I'm back from lunch at this unfashionably early hour.
It did occur to me to wonder, sir, whether there had been a conflagration at the Drones Club.
Oh, did it, Jeeves? Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, but no. Now, I was lunching with Barmy Fungi Phipps, and Barmy happened to mention that there was this stunning new song out. It's called Nagasaki. Have you heard it?
I've heard of Nagasaki, sir. A Japanese prefecture encompassing the islands of Tsushima, Iki, Hiradoshima, and, of course, the Gotoretto.
Yes, yes. Thank you, Jeeves. But apparently, that's what the song's all about. And on Barmy's recommendation, I rushed out and bought a copy. I now intend to give it a bit of a run-through on the piano.
Is that wise, sir, so soon after a heavy meal?
I shall ignore that cheap jibe, Jeeves. Were there any messages?
Just one, sir. Lady Florence Craye telephoned. She will be calling on you shortly.
Lady Florence Craye? Good heavens. Well, well, well. Good, well. Ah, Jeeves, still there, are you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, Jeeves, there was a book on the little table thing by the sofa.
Was it entitled Strength Through Willpower by Lady Florence Craye, sir?
That's the one, Jeeves.
I placed it by your bedside, sir. I took the liberty of glancing through the volume and thought it might make an excellent remedy for insomnia. Would you like me to get it, sir?
No, I'll get it, Jeeves. I just thought I'd leave it casually lying about. No, as you gave it to me, you see. Trying to improve my mind, I dare say.
That seems scarcely possible, sir.
Yes, well, toodaloo, Jeeves.
Goodbye, sir.
Jeeves, you remember we were down at Steeple Bumpley last weekend?
Yes, I do recall, sir.
Yes, Lord Warpleton's place.
Yes, sir, Lady Florence Craye's father.
Yes, yes, absolutely. Well, anyway, we're engaged. Just thought I'd let you know. To Lady Florence, that is, not her father.
Let me be the first to congratulate you, sir.
You don't disapprove, Jeeves?
It is hardly my place to say, sir.
Well, I know it's hardly your place to say, Jeeves. That doesn't normally stop you. Well, I'm glad to see you're taking it so well. So, there it is.
Fellows, if you're on, I will spin a yarn that was told to me by Abel Seaman Jones. Once he had the blues, so he took a cruise far away from nightclubs and from saxophones.
I don't think much of this, Jeeves.
No, sir.
Yeah, I think Barmy's musical prognostications have come a bit of a cropper this time. Dash boring song, that's what this is. Oh, well, I'd better push on to the end, I suppose. Ah, now, this looks a bit more promising. Yes.
Hot ginger and dynamite, there's nothing but that at night. Back in Nagasaki, where the fellows chew tobacco and the women wicky wacky woo. I knew Barmy hadn't lost his touch. Oh, Fujiyama, you get a mama, then your troubles increase. In some pagoda, she orders soda, the earth shakes, milkshakes, 10 cents apiece. They kissy and huggy nice, by jingo, it's worth the price. Back in Nagasaki, where the fellas chew tobacco and the women wicky wacky woo. You just have to act your age, or wind up inside a cage. Back in Nagasaki, where the fellas chew tobacco and the women wicky wacky woo.
Well, now, geez, that's a bit more like it, eh?
Extremely invigorating, sir.
Yes, Jeeves, that's just the word I would have used. Yes, makes you want to get up and belly well have a run around the park.
My feelings precisely, sir. That would be Lady Florence now, sir. Good afternoon, Lady Florence.
Ah, Florence.
Don't.
Oh, something up, darling.
What on earth is this?
That's a song I bought today.
Was it you making that awful row as I came up in the lift?
Well,
I thought it was the milkman.
The milkman?
You won't be able to do this when we're married.
Well, I didn't...
Do you stop interrupting, Bertram? Do you know that Sir Watkyn Bassett is my uncle?
Sir Watkyn? No, I didn't know that.
Well, he is, and he has to be stopped.
Stopped? What?
Do you be quiet for a minute and listen, Bertie. My uncle, Sir Watkyn, has written his reminiscences, recollections of a long life, he calls them. And if half of what he has written is true, then his youth must have been perfectly appalling.
Sir Watkyn, surely not a more respectable magistrate
than... Bertie! It's full of stories about people who are the essence of propriety today, but who seem to have behaved when they were in London in the 90s in a manner that would not have been tolerated in the forecastle of a whaler.
But he's always handing down lectures from the bench on the depravity of youth today.
The book opens with an account of him and my father being thrown out of a music hall in 1893.
Good Lord. Well, yes, it took quite a lot for them to chuck you out of music halls in 93.
The manuscript must be intercepted and destroyed before it reaches the publishers.
I say, how are you going to do that?
I? Oh, I have no intention of doing it. You are going to do it.
Me?
You may look on it as a test, Bertram. I will never marry you if those recollections are published.
Oh, I say, Flossie, old thing.
Kindly do not call me that.
Oh, right, Florence. What a corking girl she is, Jeeves.
So?
Lady Florence. I don't quite know who it is, but does she remind you of anyone, Jeeves?
I wouldn't like to say, sir.
Biffy Basildon, now a respected Home Secretary, once succeeded in inserting a jelly down the ceremonial breeches of a judge at the Hereford Assizes. That was before the occasion on which he...
Bertie!
Oh, Lord. What ho, Madeline!
Bertie, I must talk to you. Come here.
Wearing only a grass skirt and a guardsman's busby.
That manuscript must be destroyed, Bertie. You must get it from his safe. It's in the study.
Hold on a minute. I wasn't told about any safe. I'm not Sydney the safe breaker, you know.
Oh, Bertie. A little safe.
Well, never mind about the size of it. Why can't Gussie do it?
Oh, you are silly, Bertie. Augustus isn't a man of action like you.
Well, you know.
Augustus is a man of intellect.
What are you doing there?
Ah, Spode. Nothing.
You're Wooster, aren't you?
Yes, I was just a...
I remember you.
Oh, good. Hello, Florence. What ho, Stiffy.
What are you doing here?
I've just been asked the same question by Roderick Spode, and will give you the same reply. Nothing.
But you don't want to drink, Bertie, do you?
Rather. Wouldn't do to let the stuff go off now, would it? How stinker?
Who?
Your fiancé.
I don't have a fiancé. If a girl's fiancé can't stand up to a girl's uncle and demand a girl's hand in marriage, he has no right to call himself a fiancé.
Well, I thought he'd done all that.
He did, but Uncle Watty refused.
Well, that's hardly Stinker's fault.
He obviously didn't put enough backbone into it.
Oh, hello, Gussie. I've been looking for you.
What for?
I've got your script for you.
What ho, Gussie?
Hello, Bertie. Didn't know you were here.
Oh, yes.
Gussie's playing Pat in the Pat and Mike crosstalk act at the village concert I'm producing.
Oh, really? And who's playing Mike in this merry melange of fun and topicality?
Oates.
Oates?
You remember Police Constable Oates?
Vividly. He arrested me the last time I was down here.
Come on, Daddy.
What?
The gong's just about to go.
Oh, is
it? Yes, it is.
This bath it keeps saying in here. After nearly every line, it says bath.
That's short for business. That's where Pat hits Mike with his umbrella. One thing I want to impress on you, Gussie. When socking Constable Oates with your umbrella, I want you to let him have it with every ounce of wrist and a muscle. I want to see him come off that stage a mass of contusions.
Stephanie! Don't I know you, young man?
No. Well, that's to say, yes, but...
Oh, blast it. Won't have time for Miss Sherry.
Dinner, everybody. Bertie.
I'll just go.
Go on, Bertie.
What are you doing here?
Dinner.
Dinner? This isn't the dining room.
Isn't it? No, I thought I could smell tapioca.
The dining room's over there. You can't miss it. There are people having dinner in it.
Right.
Even the black shorts that my followers wear are symbolic.
Symbolic?
Certainly. They signify the brevity of our patience with present-day political apathy. And black is symbolic of the fact that so riddled with inefficiency is our present-day industrial structure that my suppliers ran out of all the other colours.
I say, how interesting.
Shall we leave the men to their port, lady? Thank you, Bertie.
Did you get it?
No, of course I didn't get it. Your father came in.
He can get it tonight. I've got the combination of the safe.
I'm not just going to go wandering
around. All you have to do is remember Naseby.
I don't even know him.
Battle of Naseby, you nincompoop. Where on earth did you go to school?
Eton. We didn't do safe cracking.
Battle of Naseby, 1645.
Yes?
That's it. 1645 is the combination of the safe.
Will that be all, sir?
Yes, that'll be all, Jeeves. Or rather, no. I tell you what, Jeeves, you couldn't just pop down to Sir Watkyn's study for me, could you? You'll find a safe in there, just a little one.
No, sir.
Oh, dash it all, Jeeves.
Will that be all, sir?
You're a hard man, Jeeves.
But a free one, sir, and it is my ambition to remain in that state. Good night, sir.
Question my motives. Sir Watkyn asked me to fetch some things for him.
With a sledgehammer?
He'd forgotten the combination of the safe.
Oh, well, I'll go and fetch him.
No.
I know the combination.
We don't want... The combination of the safe? Do you really, Wooster?
Certainly, but I...
Well, look, I hope that we can talk together man to man, Wooster.
I can. You're going to get up to that level.
You say such amusing things, Wooster. May I call you Bertie?
No.
All right.
You were trying to steal the manuscript, weren't you?
Manuscript? But no. Well, yes. Watkyn repeats some stories about me in there, Wooster. They'd ruin my political career. It isn't all a bed of roses trying to be a dictator, Wooster.
Why don't you give it up, then?
I can't. Well, how can I? People expect it of me. My mother.
Oh, I'm not going to stand here all night listening to you talking about your dratting mother, Spode. Come on, let's get this safe.
Yes. Of course, Wooster, you're quite right. They're clever of you to know the combination.
Now, you go and move the torch so I can see what I'm doing, all right? Now, wait a minute. Some battle or other.
Yeah, battle?
Yes, the date of the battle is the number of the combination.
Ah, Trafalgar.
No.
Hastings.
Yes. No, like Hastings. Hastings, Mason, Raisin.
I don't recall the Battle of Raisin.
Perhaps it was in the Great War. It was a joke, Spode.
I haven't got time for inane jokes, Wooster. Waterloo.
No.
Get up, Wooster.
What?
Out of the way.
Right.
The time for talking is past.
We're sure about this, aren't we, Spode?
Please don't interrupt me.
Sorry.
Stand back!
Oh, don't start all that again.
Milksop!
Good evening, sir.
What's going on?
Burglars.
Call the police.
But it's absolute balderdash, Bertie. I mean, listen to this. Shaw and Begorra, I don't know what's after being the matter with you, Michael. I mean, what on earth is this what's after being stuff mean?
My dear old Gussie, that is how people think Irish people talk. Stinker!
Bertie! I didn't know you were here.
Well, I hear that all is not moonlight and roses between you and Stiffy.
No. No, I've come up to try and reason with her.
Well, no, reason is quite what's called for, Stinker.
You know, I blame this government. The criminal classes are getting out of control.
What I want to know is, did they steal my manuscript?
Get them working on the land, that's the answer.
It ruined my safe. What's the good of having a safe if you can't open it?
This will soon be open, Sir Watkyn, sir.
You sure that's far enough from the house?
This is fine, sir. My brother-in-law at the quarry told me all the doings of that.
Mr. Pinker to see you, Miss Byng.
Hello, Stiffy.
Tell Mr. Pinker I'm not at home, Butterfield. Come on, sweetie.
Stiffy?
And matches.
Shouldn't you take cover, Oates?
Don't you worry about me, Sir Watkyn, sir.
She won't speak to me, Jeeves.
Most distressing, sir.
I mean, what do they want of us, Jeeves?
It is a question that has often been asked, sir.
What was that?
I could not say, sir.
Still here.
Great stuff, that dynamite, isn't it?
It's a bit charred. Only round the edges, though.
Bang!
I'm going to get it into the post before anyone else can try anything. Hold.
Boom. I absolutely refuse to have anything more to do with this degraded buffoonery. And when I see Stephanie, I shall tell her that she cannot play fast and loose with human dignity like this.
Hello, you two. How's it going?
What was that bang just now?
It was just Oates fooling about.
Oh. Well, Gussie's having one or two minor reservations about the sketch.
Really, Gussie? I am surprised. I thought you'd be so good for this.
Well, perhaps so.
Let me go through the script with you. Come on, show me where your problems are.
It occurs to me to wonder, sir, whether a surge of popularity for you among the villagers might not encourage Miss Byng to regard you in a more favourable light.
Oh, I don't think the villagers give me much thought at all from one Sunday to the next.
If you were to perform at the village concert, sir, and receive the acclaim of the masses, Miss Byng could be swept helplessly along in its wake.
What a wonderful idea, Jeeves. I could sing Asleep in the Deep.
A fine song, sir, and one that has redeemed the faltering career of many a bass baritone. I was thinking of something, however, which would give full play to the robuster side of your nature, sir. A hunting song, perhaps, with its poetic yet manly evocations of the merry morn and steaming horses.
Well, I can't see it, Jeeves. Even if Stinker does make a hit with his hunting song at the concert, I can't see that Stiffy's going to say, "Oh, Stinker," and fling herself into his arms.
Possibly not, sir, but it might make him more resolute.
Ah! You mean that if he does make a hit, he might get it up his nose to such an extent that he'll be able to look Sir Watkyn in the eye and make him wilt?
The theory is a tenable one, sir.
Well, it's more tenable, Jeeves. It's a pip. Right, but what we must do then is to strain every nerve to see that he does make a hit. Now what are those things that people have?
Sir?
You know, opera singers, people like that.
Ah, you mean a clack.
That's the one. He must be provided with a clack. It will be your task, Jeeves, to move about the village, dropping a word here, standing a beer there, until the whole community is impressed with the necessity of cheering Stinker until their eyes bubble. I can leave this to you.
I shall attend to the matter directly, sir.
Wooster. Bertram, you've got to do it now.
Do it? I can't.
Uncle Watkyn has just put it out to be posted to the publishers. You've got to get it before Butterfield takes it to the post office.
Well...
And destroy every page of it. Everyone's relying on you.
Makes a lot of sense sometimes.
Oh, yes.
But you also have extraordinary sensitivity, Bertie.
Really? Yes.
What are you doing with that parcel?
Parcel?
That.
Oh, that? Oh, yeah, no, that's not a parcel, Gussie. No, it is a parcel, but...
Anyway, I can't stand here talking about parcels. I'm off for rehearsals.
Jeeves? I've got it.
Sir?
Sir Watkyn's manuscript. All we have to do now is destroy the dreaded thing.
Yes, sir.
Right. Well, yes. Recollections of a long time, honestly. Well, yes. Jeeves, light the fire, will you?
Very good, sir.
Burn the thing, that's the way.
One page at a time, sir?
Good Lord. Yes, well, perhaps two. Oh, heavens, Jeeves, this is going to take an eon.
Perhaps we should leave it until we have more time at our disposal, sir.
Jeeves, you're right. Yes, we'll decide what to do with it later. Now then, normality, Jeeves, that's the thing, normality at all times.
Your jacket, sir?
Oh, yes, jacket, yes.
Oh, you're here at last, are you?
Some of us have duties to perform, miss.
Your duty is to get a rehearsal on time, Constable Oates. We'll start from the top of page two. Get up on the stage, Oates. Gussie, you start.
Sure and begorra. How are you after getting on with that new glass eye of yours, Mike?
Is that dog secure, Miss Byng?
Never mind about the dog.
A hunting we will go, a hunting we will go, a hunting we will go, a hunting we will go.
Is that it?
No, that's just the first verse. It goes on, a hunting we will go.
Well, Stinker, I'm not altogether sure that Stiffy's going to go for this, you know. You see, the trouble is you start off A hunting we will go, a hunting we will go. And then just as the audience is all keyed up for a punchline, you repeat that, a hunting we will go. There will be a sense of disappointment, Stinker. Fruit will be flung.
You think so?
Oh, sure of it.
No. Can't you make some attempt at an Irish accent, Oates?
Well, I'm sorry to be telling you this, Pat, but it's an absolute failure.
But how is that now?
Yes, sure. What is it? God, these interruptions.
Oh, no, Stiffy, we wanted to have a word with you.
Well, you'll have to wait, I'm afraid. All right, Gussie, darling. Oates, do that speech again.
Sure, and it's got no hole in it, as I can see through.
Go on.
And tell me, Mike.
No, you've missed out the business, Gussie.
Oh, the umbrella, you mean?
Absolutely.
Oh,
pardon you.
Dear.
What's the matter?
This gentleman just hit me on the head with his umbrella.
He's so stupid, Oates. That's Biz. Gussie, darling, show him, will you?
Again?
Put a bit of muscle into it this time. You have no right to arrest Bartholomew. I've had to sack him, of course.
From the sketch?
Yes.
Stephanie just told him there and then. He was still lying there, all tangled up in the scenery. She was absolutely fearless.
The man's an oaf, anyway. Uncle Roderick will do it much better.
What?
A deeply disturbing thing has happened. Earlier today, I prepared my manuscript for dispatch to Messrs. Riggs and Ballinger, the publishers. I placed it on the hall table in the normal manner, but Butterfield is unswerving in his assertion that when he went to collect the letters, there was no parcel among them. I believe that the parcel has been stolen.
Well, who would want to steal your manuscript?
Bertie, you had a parcel when I saw you in the hall earlier.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did, you ass.
Oh, yes. A parcel, you mean? Yes, that's quite right. Well done, Gussie. Yes, nothing to do with this, though.
What parcel was this, Wooster?
Oh, nothing special. Usual sort of brown paper affair. Bit of string, suspicion of sealing wax, that's all.
I'm going to search this room, Wooster. If I find what I'm looking for, then I intend to put you in the charge of Constable Oates.
Oh, I say, now look here. You look.
I am fully aware that there are people who wish to prevent my work being published.
Ah, jeez. Sir Watkyn seems to think that I've swiped his memoirs.
Indeed, sir.
Well, tell him I haven't.
This drawer appears to be locked.
Ah, yes, well, I don't worry about that one. It's locked and all that sort of thing.
I rather fancy that this might be the key that you were looking for, Sir Watkyn. It was in the pocket of the suit you wore for rehearsal, sir.
Yes, well, whatever's in there, I didn't know anything about it. Well, I don't know what it is, so I couldn't...
It's empty!
Did you find it, Daddy?
No, I did not. Someone's got it, though. I shall not rest, Madeline, until I find it.
I removed the parcel this afternoon, sir. I thought it best.
Yeah, it certainly was, Jeeves. It's a Watkyn on the rampage. It's in a safe place, though, eh?
Oh, indeed, sir.
Well, you'd better hang on to the beastly thing till we get back to London.
Very good, sir.
We'll find a way of disposing of it there.
So, you've done it.
Rather.
And it's destroyed.
Yes, absolutely.
Well done, Bertie. Well done.
I say, Florence, you know, there's a lovely moon tonight.
Moon?
Out there, you know, as in moon. I wonder if you'd like to go for a walk.
No.
4 o'clock in the morning. Sure, the cockle will start to crow. Divil a bit of sleep do I get after that.
Faith and begob, isn't that a terrible thing, Mike?
But wasn't I after getting the better of him, Pat?
You did?
I did. Sure, and I bought the birds myself. I keep them in my garden now. Let them keep him awake. Never do that again, Fink-Nottle.
I do that after every joke.
No, no, you don't.
It's all right, Uncle Roderick. He has to do it. It's part of the fun.
Fun?
I'll talk to you about it later. That's all for today. Mrs. Blackett?
Yes?
Now, look here, Stiffy. We've got to get this Gussie thing straight.
What Gussie thing? All right, Mrs. Blackett, off you go.
You know perfectly well what Gussie thing, young Stiffy. For reasons into which we need not go, you have recently been treating Augustus Fink-Nottle as the plaything of an idle hour. Well, it's got to stop.
All right, Mrs. Blackett, you can start.
You are aware that if sand is shoved into the gears of the Fink-Nottle-Bassett romance to the point where it ceases to tick over, Bertram Wooster is going to be facing the fate that is worse than death, his marriage.
You want me to switch off the fascination? Release Gussie from my clutches?
Atta girl.
Well, I can't. At least not yet. There's a little job I want him to do for me first.
Stiffy!
I'm only surprised you haven't turned professional, Gussie.
Really?
It's not only a matter of your talent. You have an air of self-confidence about you.
Excuse me, Stephanie.
Oh, hello, Byng.
All eyes are drawn to you.
I've been trying to speak to you, Stephanie.
Oh, yes, Harold, what is it?
I'd like to sing at the concert.
Sing?
Mm-hmm.
You? Well, we have a very full programme already. What do you think, Gussie?
Well...
All right. We'll think about it later. Now, to get back to what we were talking about, Gussie. The little thing I want you to do with Constable Oates. Well, he's still got Bartholomew in custody.
Afternoon, miss.
Good afternoon.
That's all for today, then.
Thank you, postman.
Bye.
Oh, Mr. Ballinger, I thought you'd like to know that manuscript we thought was lost has turned up. Sir Watkyn Bassett's memoirs.
Gentlemen, once again, it is my pleasure to welcome you to the annual Totleigh in the World concert.
And now, play the violin for us, Winnie...
Constable Oates,
what do you want?
I feel it my duty to warn you, officer, that there is the likelihood of a disturbance in there at some point during the evening.
A disturbance?
You ought to be on hand to quell any unrest.
Thank you.
Your rector would just like to show his profound gratitude for the rousing cheer that he knows you're going to give him for his performance this evening.
Oh. Where's my umbrella?
I've warned you!
Thank you, Winnie Blackett. What a treat. And now, ladies and gentlemen, a pair of old favorites. Your friends and mine from the Emerald Isle, Pat and Mike.
Ah, the top of the morning to you, Michael. And how are you today?
Sure, I'm well enough, Patrick. I'm looking for a cap that I can wear when I'm riding my motorcycle.
And can you not buy a cap to wear on your motorcycle?
Devil a bit I can, Pat. None of the shops sells one with a peak at the back.
Gussie, come on!
Did I not see you walking down the street?
Well, now, Pat, it's time for me to be on my way. I'm after looking for some oil for my motorcycle.
Oil, if it? Can you not be after getting some from the garage?
Well, no. Pat, it's got to be special oil. It's for my rear lamp, you see, so it's got to be red.
Hit him, Gussie, hit him.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, our curate, the Reverend Harold Pinker, to entertain us with a hunting song.
To the merry horn, upon this jolly hunting morn, over brake and over thorn, a hunting we will go.
Hunting we will go, a hunting we will go. Pull up your socks and chase the fox, a hunting we will go. A hunting we will go, a hunting we will go.
I think he's gone. I say, Bertie, do you think he'll get me some brandy?
You mean orange juice?
I mean brandy, another bucket full.
Large brandy for Mr. Fink-Nottle. Soda, Gussie? Apparently. You are sure about this, are you?
Yes, I am.
Oh. Chin-chin.
Oh, what a appalling mug. Like vitriol. How on earth can you drink this stuff for pleasure?
Well, what are you drinking it for?
I'm drinking it because I've heard it's the stuff to nerve you for frightful ordeals.
The ordeal is over, Gussie.
Oh, no, it isn't. Spode's after me because I hit him with my umbrella. Also, I've got to go and break into a police station and steal a dog.
Say that again.
I've promised Stephanie I'll go to Oates Cottage and extract that dog of hers.
But, Gussie, you can't do that. She'll get 30 days in the jug.
For Stephanie's sake, I'd do a year. Anyway, there's no chance of my being caught. Oates is still watching the concert.
You sure?
I saw him myself.
Well, all the same.
Stephanie wants me to extract her dog, and I'm going to do it. Gussie, she said to me, Gussie, you're such a help. I intend to be worthy of those words. Oh. Goodbye, Bertie.
Ah, Jeeves. So, what did you make of the crosstalk act?
Well, to my immense chagrin, sir, I missed that part of the entertainment. I was, however, in place with my clack in time for Mr. Pinker's hunting song.
And how was that?
Well, sir, I can only say that I enjoyed it considerably more than did Constable Oates, who was standing nearby.
Well, I didn't care for it, eh?
No, sir. When Mr. Pinker had finished, he said that he could abide no more and that he was going home.
Oh. What?
House is,
yes, sir.
We'll be in time. By now, Oates will be sitting on Gussie's chest, slipping the cuffs on him.
Bertie?
Stiffy? What are you doing here? You're supposed to be producing that ghastly entertainment.
I thought it was going rather well. There's nothing more I can do anyway.
Oh, I see. So having lured Gussie into de-dogging Constable Oates, you're just going to sit here vainly hoping that he'll do it. Well, let me tell you, my child, that Oates is at home.
Fancy that may be the little fellow now, sir.
Here comes Bartholomew. Come on, Bartholomew! Time to be leaving, I think.
Well, geez, I hope I'm man enough to admit when I've been wrong. Gussie has quite obviously managed to...
I fear the worst, sir.
Oh, Jeeves, I think you're right. I'd never give you any sort of odds on Gussie as a sprinter on the flat.
Stop, you
bastard! Oh, Bertie!
Oh, I'm surprised, Jeeves.
Indeed, sir. One only wishes one had advanced notice of this kind of form. Mr. Fink-Nottle's ankle work was extremely convincing.
It was, wasn't it?
Perhaps one should have had a wager on this, sir.
Yes, he should do it at a canter.
Indeed, he should, sir.
Come on now, it's a fair cop.
Yes, of course, what one has not borne in mind, Jeeves, is that Mr. Fink-Nottle is also a fathead. I mean, Constable Oates may not be one of Gloucestershire's brightest thinkers, but he's smart enough to stand under a tree.
Get down now, come on.
Perhaps I might intervene, sir.
Intervene, Jeeves?
Come on.
Oh, I see what you mean.
If you care to look the other way, sir.
Get out of that train out. You're under arrest. I can wait here all night, you know.
Good Lord, Jeeves.
I thought it the safest way to avoid unpleasantness, sir. I think you'll find it safe to descend now, sir.
Ah, thank you, Jeeves.
Yes, Mr. Ballinger. Yes. I will see that Sir Watkyn gets your message as soon as possible. Goodbye, sir.
Do you know what it is, Bertie, to have the scales fall from your eyes?
Oh, yes. Happens all the time.
They have fallen from mine. And I'll tell you when it happened. It was when I was up in that tree, gazing down at Constable Oates and hearing him describe the situation of a fair cop. In a flash, love died.
Whose love?
Mine, you ass! For Stephanie. I still admire her enormously, of course. But, you know, I feel I need someone less exciting.
Stiffy is a fine person, Gussie. Admirably suited to be the bride of someone who won't object to her landing him on the whim of the moment in a cell at one of our more popular prisons. But the girl for you is quite obviously Madeline Bassett. Well, it will be a genuine pleasure for me to weigh in with the silver egg boiler, or whatever you suggest, as a wedding present.
Ladies and gentlemen! A most remarkable thing has happened. I've just been informed that the manuscript of my memoirs, which I thought had been lost, has arrived at my publisher's office. I cannot imagine what kind of caused the delay, but it makes this a day of celebration. Thank you.
Bertie!
I can't understand it. I simply cannot understand it.
Well, I can. I understand it perfectly. You funked it.
No, I mean...
Perhaps you think I didn't mean what I said I did. Well, I did.
Well, yes.
Our engagement is over.
Oh, now, Florence,
I consider I've had a very lucky escape.
That seems to be that, Bertie.
Quiet, please.
And look.
I wish to announce that Miss Stephanie Byng and I are getting married.
No, look here.
Quiet, please. The wedding will take place on September the 3rd.
I must protest.
Sir Watkyn, please. And you're all invited.
Oh, isn't he wonderful? Isn't he wonderful? Oh!
Jeeves!
Yes, sir.
That parcel has arrived in London.
Yes, sir.
Well, did you send it?
Yes, sir. Huh? I acted for the best, sir.
You do know that Lady Florence has broken off her engagement with me.
In my opinion, sir, and I'm sorry if this causes you any distress, you and Lady Florence are not ideally matched. Her ladyship is of a highly arbitrary and determined temperament, sir, quite opposed to your own.
Oh, indeed, Jeeves. Oh, I'm very grateful for your opinion. But I must say that what I had in mind from you was abject, quivering apology. Well, this is very sad, Jeeves. But I'm going to have to think very seriously about your future.
Are you a potter or an ostler? I trust that is not alcohol I smell on your breath. Drunkenness may be de rigueur among the servants at some houses, but I should be sorry to see it take hold here.
My lady?
I suggest you read these. They're a brief introduction to the beliefs and aims of the Theosophical Society. Study them well.
Thank you, my lady.
Yes, lady.
Yes, well, I've thought seriously about your future, Jeeves, and I think it should continue very much in the vein of your immediate past. I owe you an apology, Jeeves.
By no means, sir.
Remember me asking you if Lady Florence reminded you of anyone, Jeeves?
Indeed I do, sir.
Yes, well, I've just realised who it is, my Aunt Agatha.
The comparison is perhaps a felicitous one, sir. I was for nearly a year in the service of the young lady's father, Lord Warpleston, during which time I had ample opportunity to study her ladyship. Her cognomen in the servants' hall was Lady Caligula, sir.
I'm going to tell you!
Old Gussie seems to live only for excitement, Jeeves.
Indeed, sir, he does seem to attract the attention of the rougher element. But to revert to the question of the manuscript, sir, in my opinion, Lady Florence has overestimated the danger of people being offended at being mentioned in Sir Watkyn's book. In my experience, many respectable old gentlemen are by no means averse to having it advertised to their extreme wife.